Hello students, today we discuss about the translation process. What is translation? That is, and where it done and why it is required, the translation for protein synthesis. That, what is meant by synthesis? You know very well what is the role of protein. That is, protein is a very important factor to do all metabolic activities done inside by the cell. Okay. Then this protein synthesis, that synthesis, what is my synthesis? Synthesis is nothing but to make something, right? To make something. That is, a translation is the mechanism in which codons of mRNA, here we found these are the codons, right? The triplet is called as, this triplet on mRNA strand is called as codon, right? Codons of mRNA are translated and specifies amino acid in a sequence from a polypeptide on ribosome. Polypeptide, for the formation of polypeptide chain, this mRNA required certain kinds of character transporting system, and that system is mRNA. Then, in a sequence form of polypeptide chain, here the sequence form of polypeptide chain. What is polypeptide chain? That is nothing but a form of protein molecule. Okay, and where they form the polypeptide chain? With the help of all the ribosomes. All types of proteins are synthesized by the cell. All type of protein, that is synthesized by whom? That is the cell. Within itself, cell, inside the cell, it happens inside the cell. That is the process of protein synthesis. The process of translation requires amino acids. What the process of translation is, this process, what they need? They need amino acids, then mRNA, here mRNA, then here tRNA, this is tRNA, ribosome, this is a ribosome, then ATP molecules. ATP is, that is a energy package for the process. Mg plus ion is required to attachment of these large ribosome, large subunit of ribosome and small subunit of ribosome. For that, the Mg plus 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 ion, that is ions, and certain enzymes, elongation, then certain enzymes also required there. Then elongation, translation and release factor, all those things is elongation, translation and release factor, all these things are very important, play a very important role there. Then first, amino acid form a row amino acid is nothing but that is a raw material. Amino acid is nothing but form a raw material for a protein synthesis. About 20 different types of amino acids are known to form protein present in cytoplasm. This all activity where it done inside the cell. That's why cytoplasm is also play important role. That is, that protein is present inside the cytoplasm. Then another thing is, DNA controls synthesis. What DNA? DNA control synthesis of protein having amino acid, okay, in specific sequence. No, here one second, no, in a specific sequence. This control possible through transportation of mRNA, through the transcription of mRNA. And another thing is, genetic code is a specific for particular amino acid. Genetic code If this is a one sort of genetic code here, then this genetic code having kinds of particular amino acid, okay, then that its genetic code is specific for a particular amino acid, then RNA serve as a intermediate molecule between DNA and protein. RNA play a very important role in the process of protein synthesis. Then ribosome here these are the ribosomes. These all here in the, all this process there is a major major role of ribosome. Ribosome serve as a site for protein synthesis. Okay, they serve the site for protein synthesis. Each ribosome contains a large and small subunit. Each ribosome contains large and small subunit, right? Occurs separately in cytoplasm. They are present separately in cytoplasm. And where cytoplasm present, you people know very well. Then only during protein synthesis they are combined. These two subunits get associated when at the time of protein synthesis. Get associated together due to Mg++ ion here. These Mg++ ion they combine these two, this large subunit and this small subunit, they combine with the help of this Mg++ ion. Okay, then ribosome has a one binding site for mRNA. Ribosome has a one binding site for mRNA and three binding site for tRNA. One binding site and three binding site of for the tRNA. They are P site here. They are these three site here. P site here. Sorry, this is P site. Then A site and E is here. E site. These are the three sites, okay, for three binding site for tRNA. They are what? They are P site. They are A site, P site, and E site. Then A. What is the A site? Okay, only first tRNA amino acid complex directly enters a P site for ribosome. What? Only first tRNA. Here, this first tRNA. What they do? First tRNA amino acid complex directly enter a P site of ribosome. Directly enter to the P site. Here, enter this RNA enters to the P site. First one. Then, mechanism of translation, that is a synthesis of polypeptide chain. It involves three steps, that is initiation, elongation, and termination. Then, here, initiation is the stand for initiation. Then, B stand for elongation. Then, T stand for termination. All this diagram, they represent all these activity they perform inside the cell. What happened there? Here, this diagram is also helpful for to understand this translation process of synthesis. Then, what happened here? Here, this nucleosome, you know, which studied in previous lecture, that is basis of nucleotides. The basis of nucleotides. These are the basis of nucleotides. They comes together in DNA. The basis, they carry some certain kinds of information. For carrying certain kind of information. Then when they come towards the DNA, that site is called as promoter site. What called? this site is called a promoter site, because it promotes something, it promotes a proteosynthesis process. That's why this site is called a promoter site. Then after that promoter site, here the with the help of these hydrogen bonds, the formation of hydrogen bond, they transfer certain character, they transfer certain information about the photosynthesis on this nucleotide, basis of nucleotides, and after that they comes out in the form of mRNA. And this mRNA here, this mRNA having certain information. And which type of information? What type of information? That is a formation of polypeptide chain. Okay? Then this mRNA here, we take this mRNA here. And on this mRNA, we found these codons. Here, 1, 2, 3. This codon carries certain kinds of information. Then, what happened here? This tRNA carrying certain kinds of information also. Then, when this, I already told you, this P, this tRNA, the first tRNA that comes towards this P site, directly come toward the P site, and this anticodons of the tRNA, here the anticodons of tRNA and the codons of this mRNA, they bind here and they carry certain information, they share certain information, and they after that they are again. This tRNA, look here, this tRNA carry information, get information about a formation of polypeptide chain, and here one molecule is formed. After that, this ribosome get shifted towards next codon, and when this ribosome shifted next to next codon, then what tRNA comes to this from the A site. This tRNA come to carrying certain information and come toward the T site. When this tRNA shifted here, at the same time, and this again one tRNA come here, and at that time this polypeptide, the one molecule of polypeptide is come to here, and they form a one molecule. They form a two molecules here. One molecule of polypeptide chain of two molecules are formed here. Right. Then again, this tRNA comes. Okay. Then this come to the for P side. A site, then after that this ribosome again put forward, and then this polypeptide molecule then again jump on this P site ribosome, the P site tRNA, that is in where, that is 3'N. Then here after the completion, after the long chain of reading of this long chain of mRNA, there a formation of polypeptide chain. This polypeptide chain, after the formation of polypeptide chain, there is a stop codon. You know stop codon, that is UAA, AUG and UJA. These stop codons, they don't have any type of formation of polypeptide chain, any type of information to formation of polypeptide chain. That's why we call it as a stop codon and carrying that tRNA. Then after the formation of polypeptide chain, this codon comes toward, that is a stop codon. This stop codon comes toward the mRNA, and this all this formation of polypeptide chain, the process of formation of polypeptide chain stop there. Then what happened there? There formation of polypeptide chain. This polypeptide chain in the form of protein molecules, after the completion of, we found this is in the form of, this polypeptide chain is in present in the form of protein molecule. Then these large subunit of ribosome and small subunit of ribosome, they are also detached from there. Then this tRNA also lost there, and this release of mRNA also happened there. And what happened in this process, what happened, we found the formation of polypeptide chain, and that polypeptide chain is nothing but that is a our protein molecule. This is about the translation process, the translation in protein synthesis. Then another point is regulation of gene expression. What is mean by regulation of gene expression? It is a multi-step process by which a gene is regulated and its product is synthesized. Thus, gene expression result in the form of polypeptide chain. We already discussed what is polypeptide chain in eukaryotes. What is eukaryotes? You know very well. Then in eukaryotes, the regulation can be at different level. In eukaryotes, there is a regulation of protein is synthesis is at different level. The first is transcription level. Transcription level, you know very well, and you understand. I hope you understand it very well. One form in transcription level, there is a formation of primary transcription. Okay. Then in second processing level, regulation of splicing, then transport of mRNA from nucleus to the cytoplasm, that is a transport of mRNA from here, from nucleus, this where this present inside the nucleus, from here is the transportation of mRNA from the nucleus to the cytoplasm. Here it's come out of the nucleus inside the cytoplasm, right? Understand? And translation level, okay. Then gene of a cell are expressed to perform different functions. For example, an enzyme beta galactose is synthesized by E. coli bacteria, and you know in previous lecture we discussed about the E. coli bacteria. Scientists used E. coli bacteria in various experiments. It is used for hydrolysis of lactic in galactose and glucose, right? Then what is that process? That process is a very simple process. That process is very simple process. That is lactose here. The lactose we found in presence of beta, inside the beta galactose. And for that it needs a water molecule. After that, what happened? A galactose plus a glucose molecule. A glucose molecule is formed there. Certain bacteria like E. coli adapt to their chemical environment by synthesizing certain enzymes. Depending upon the substrate present, such adaptive enzyme is called inducible enzyme, that is a set of gene will be switched on when there is a necessity to metabolize. What is that? That is energy formation. Metabolize is into two forms. That is catabolism. What is meant by catabolism? That is a breakdown of energy, right? And anabolism, that is a building molecule to form a molecules, to form a buildings of molecule. And this process is also a formation of molecules. That is, this we can call it as anabolic process. This is also an anabolic process. Then, and this breaking is called breaking of molecule. If these molecules are formed, that is called, that process is as anabolism. If these molecules are break, this is called as catabolism. Okay, then a new substrate, this phenomena is called as induction, and a small molecule responsible for this is known as inducer. Okay, it is a positive control. This is called as a positive control. This is all about the translation of protein synthesis and all these processes, where they take place and where they happen. I hope you understand all these things. Thank you.